divorce is such a big deal, and most people don't realize it. A friend of mine said recently, and he said this, and this is aggressive, and you know, people are going to get angry. But when you are a child of divorce, it really extinguishes the hope that you're really ever going to have a normal, and I don't want to use the word normal, but a conventional life. Like, I think the way that he worded it is you're just kind of like, you're fucked. You're damaged. Now, because everything is so bad now, divorce barely registers as something that damages people. Mommy and daddy going, you know what? We're not into this anymore. And we're barely into you. Because that's what a divorce is at the end of the day. It's them going, we're so not into each other that you are no longer even uniting us. For a few years, you actually were the drive. Because that's also why people get divorced, because they don't have kids. You need to have a child if you're married. Because otherwise, what are you doing? It's stupid. Marriage without children is kind of dumb, unless you were like trying, if you're running like an empire and your days are full of meetings and whatever it is, and you know, going on, you know, retreats and whatever it is that keeps you and that person really. I'm friends with divorce attorneys. These kids have to go and testify in a court. Do you know how much this fucks up children, having to testify and get cross-examined and then bringing in experts and stuff like that? But divorce is one of those things that does fuck kids up. Nobody cares, but it does. I'm not saying, and listen, obviously don't stay together if it's the worst marriage in the world. That can also fuck kids up. That's people's argument. They're like, well, should we stay together if we're just beating each other? It's like, no, the goal would be to not be in the worst marriage in the world. To try to not get into that. Now, obviously, sometimes that just happens. I get it. The reality is divorce is a thing. People act like it's not a thing. People tend to think it like doesn't matter. But it's traumatizing, especially if it goes on for a while. Like, my parents' divorce went on for 2 years because neither one of them could afford to get lawyers. So they had a mediator. And a mediator just comes to your house and your parents just argue at a dining room table over a collection of Beanie Babies or whatever the fuck they had. These fucking boomers had nothing. Aunt Gussie's table. I remember my mother said that. She goes, well, who's going to get Aunt Gussie's table? And I'm like, hi, I'm 13 and I'm about to embark on a decade of drug use. Could one of you maybe check in perhaps while we're dividing up a table that has a market value of at best $75? I'm a living organism that you both have created. So could potentially maybe you find the time to check in on how I'm doing while you divide up all the winnings of 20 years of having no college education and no financial planning, okay? And believing you could retire by collecting Hess trucks and then putting them in a room. And my father, who I love, who came to my show last night in New York, but my dad being a musician, and, you know, his most prized possessions were his guitars. That's why all marriages fail for the most part, is because you have too little money or you have too much money. And if you have too much money, you go, why am I fucking you? What you need in a marriage is just enough money to keep people doing it. But you need a little bit of fear. You need a little bit of the idea of like, can we afford this divorce? What happens? What happens on the other side of this? If everyone is too comfortable, one of my friends is a divorce lawyer in Beverly Hills. Too much comfort breeds just people going, you know what? I don't know. I don't know anymore. You don't really excite me. But just enough money, just enough, keeps people like my parents in a loveless marriage for 20 years and ruins their children's life. So that's what you want. You want just enough money to keep things going.